Sarah Coffman has always loved animals.
I remember sitting in the parking lot of the grocery store while my parents were inside shopping. And I saw this kitten run through the parking lot, so I got out and I went and climbed underneath this car and I grabbed this kitten and I put it under my shirt and I got back in the car in the back of the van. And on the way home, you hear this meow start coming out of the back seat. And I remember my dad being like, "Why is the back seat meowing?" So stories like that were always happening.
And could say those stories are still happening today, only more often and on a much larger scale. Sarah is the founder and executive director of WAAL, the Wichita Animal Action League. In its first year, it rescued 47 animals. In 2018, that number had grown to nearly 800.
WAAL started, honestly, with someone sharing a post on Facebook. There was a post that had been making its rounds. It was a really cold night and people were talking about a dog that had been abandoned at a house and that they were concerned that it was going to freeze to death. And everyone was sharing this Facebook post saying, "Oh my gosh, someone do something." And I was like, "I'm someone. I don't know what to do, but I can try." And another woman kind of had the same thought. We private messaged each other, had never met before in our lives, and loaded up that night and went and rescued that dog. And it just kind of snowballed from there. And I was like, that was a lot of fun. Little did I know that it would completely consume all of my time and my life.
Taking that proactive step to do something has made all the difference. And now, WAAL's three main services include fostering and adoption of animals, community outreach, and the Spay It Forward program, which battles overpopulation to reduce unnecessary euthanasia.
Our overall goal is to rescue animals in crisis, but that crisis can look very different based on the situation. And sometimes when you rescue the animal in crisis, you also have to rescue the person that's in crisis with that animal. So we've kind of broadened our scope to not just focus on the pet, but to also keep the owner in mind.
To be effective in each of the organization's areas of focus, it takes lots of people and partners. WAAL has more than 120 foster families who take in animals for short periods of time. It has volunteers who help in a variety of other ways, but they all share the same passion.
It's really easy to lose sight of the big picture when you're in animal rescue, and coming into animal control and seeing the faces that people are sharing on Facebook saying, you know, this dog's gonna die tomorrow, this cat's gonna die tomorrow. And knowing that in the last minutes, we can be the difference between a second chance and a happily ever after and death for that animal. I think that's what fuels everyone who's on the WAAL team.
One of the amazing aspects of the Wichita Animal Action League is that it currently does its rescue work without a physical building. The organization coordinates home fosters and works with a few local pet businesses for temporary boarding until permanent homes can be found. There is one exception. On Saturdays from 11 a.m. until 3, a storefront in Town West Mall turns into a WAAL adoption center.
And it's extremely beneficial for us because we catch a lot of foot traffic from the mall who had no idea that we were there, who had no idea that we even existed. We're inside on the east side of the mall by JCPenney's across from Annie Ann Pretzels. So we always joke, go get a pretzel and then come adopt a cat.
Sarah and her husband personally have 2 cats and 3 dogs, plus have fostered more than 200 animals. But she is doing less fostering these days to spend more time running the organization. And she gives credit to all of the many volunteers and partners who make WAAL work.
There are so many people that are doing so much more than what I feel like I'm doing within WAAL. You know, we have fosters that have fostered over 100 dogs single-handedly by themselves. I have a great board of directors that are way more involved than any board of directors ever wants to be or should be. You know, they're volunteering every weekend. They're doing dog adoptions. It's really kind of overwhelming to see how the community has come together to work towards one effort and one goal.